My reaction when I heard the YMCA wanted me to be the VIP this year was I didn't really have much of a reaction. I didn't really feel like I was special in any way. I didn't feel like I was doing anything out of the ordinary.
I think our contribution is nothing different than what anybody else could do. We just try to be there, and if somebody needs help and we're able to help, that's the lesson that I try to instill in my children. But I don't think we're any different than anybody else.
Dan's son actually works for me, and I told him, like, your dad chose us for an award. He's like, sweet, like, I won an award. And that's how I do view it. Like, it's not a me thing.
It's not an everyday thing when you get picked for something like this. So, I was very surprised.
I was surprised. I was surprised. I wasn't expecting it.
I was thrilled and very much honored.
Okay, my reaction was when I was picked as the VIP is I was happy. I mean, I'm glad that all these people here thought of me, you know?
I was happy, excited, and I was in shock.
It was just a big shock and a really nice one.
That's a jolly good question, and I could not begin to guess. And the reason for that is that I don't do anything that anybody else at the Y couldn't or doesn't do. The most important thing to me are the friendships that have been formed. We'd go over here to the Boulevard and we'd order dinner, and we buy each other birthday cards. So we decided instead of buying all those cards, we'd just take the money that we were going to spend on cards and put it in a little mission box. Our tiny little bird group has done a lot over the years with that money. We would support the Pedal with a Purpose. We would do Good Neighbors. We'd buy Easter baskets, meals. We'd help people buy school clothes. Whatever money we had that month, we would support projects like that. So that's what we've done with our little bird's nest money.
I'm not a leader, I don't think, but I like to help people. I mean, anybody wants help with something out there, I'll help them. Or if Lori needs help, I mean, she knows that. If she needed something done and right now and said, God, I have nobody to do it, I'd do it. You know, that's the way I am.
I keep everybody moving, and I keep them associating, coming and enjoying each other when they sit out at the tables and before dancing and get together, you know, their conversation. They enjoy meeting each other.
I nominated Ms. Ramaya to be the VIP for Hope YMCA because she is so helpful, she's very talented, and she is very important to the YMCA. Right, Ramaya?
Yes.
Yes.
I was starting to see the numbers in the program starting to decline a little bit, and so I just kind of took it upon myself to put a program together for the adventure guides for recruitment to help bring more people into the program. The reason I did it is because I believed in it so strongly.
Hey, Haley is a new executive director. So as she came in and as I was part of the board and became chair of the board, it was an opportunity for me to maybe do a little mentoring, to also help Haley, who has a great strength in childcare, as she kind of grew her leadership, to help her leverage that into the other areas that the YMCA, as an executive director of any facility, needs to deal with.
I think they picked me because I showed up to every practice and game and gave it my all.
You know, we always get involved in whatever our kids do.
So we just kind of asked Susan, hey, you know, if you need any help, like we're willing and we're able to help. And then it just kind of started from there, doing, you know, little things, helping with like the spring war show.
Back in 2017 with Fat Tees Cookies, we came up with our summer seasonal cookie Schmummer Camp, s'mores cookie, just summer vibes at an all-time high. And I always wanted to find a way to give back to Rotary Camp, and Schmummer Camp seemed like that perfect way. So since 2017, we've been giving half of the net proceeds from that cookie back to camp, specifically for camperships to send kids to camp for the summer.
I'd say the biggest is in fundraising, not only in donations myself, but organizing events, working at events, volunteering here, volunteering there. Of lately, the last maybe 5 or 6 years, I'm the one person that makes bags for wine bottles for the annual fundraiser. So making 50 bags takes a little bit of time. I think the contribution I make probably more than anything is my attitude.
I've been here since I was a baby.
I was like 5 when I started playing for the Y.
I have been involved in the YMCA since I was a little kid, growing up and walking to my YMCA in Pennsylvania. And when I came out here to Akron to work for Bridgestone, we found a Firestone Park YMCA.
My involvement with the Akron Rotary Camp started back in 2011. I started working here as a camp counselor.
I started here 19 years ago, and so over the years, I get to know everybody here because everybody here is really friendly. So I got to know all these people, and they started asking me to do stuff like do classes, help with this, help with that, and I just said yes to everything.
Way back in like 2003, a friend of mine, we were at a party together, and he was telling me about a program that he was in through the YMCA called the Indian Guides and Indian Princesses.
Well, I've been here for 12 years teaching line dancing. And I also bring my grandson here for boxing and swimming too, so I'm pretty much involved in the Y.
Our daughter started taking lessons at the Equestrian Center summer of 2018, and we just wanted to support her and make sure that she was having a positive experience.
Boy, my involvement is quite a bit, actually, and it started about 10 years ago when I became a member, which was a dream come true.